Steve is with me here. He's making a muscle. He's making a muscle, and I go for a kick, and he goes for a kick. And he keeps hands up, and we go. And he goes. And he goes. And make a muscle to it. Keep your hands up. Because that's what I will do in a fight. If I do it twice, and I see a person start to get this, and then I do one, and then I see this, and I do this. It's over. Guys, what you see, that even a heavy guy with strong legs, when you do the kick correct, he feels the weight of the kick. And that's what I want to do. And through all my experience teaching, people usually don't know how to shift the weight correct. Here's the principle. Follow it. It will help you for every movement you make. We will agree that we have to hit the target 20 degrees. Meaning, if this is my target still in front here, and I want to hit it straight forward, I'm not going to hit it like this, because it will not be the target. Right? I'm stating the obvious. So in order to hit it straight, I will have to meet it 90 degrees. Even if it's a hook, it will be 90 degrees. Even if it's an uppercut, it will be 90 degrees. If it's a kick to the groin, it will be still even under 90 degrees. If it's to the body, and that's the best example for it, if I just do a front kick, it will go 180 degrees to the target, it will not hit the target. So I need to hit it 90 degrees. So that means that I will have to make it this way, 90 degrees. So if I make a low kick, it will not be this. You can put this there. This is it. It will not be this. You see? Where it's slip. I will bring my knee up, make a muscle. This way. 90 degrees. This is not only a drill to make the kick correct, it's a drill to build your shin. And it's a drill to build also the absorber mind. Because a lot of people worry from that. They worry from that. They go for it. In reality, as he does this once, I says, okay, that's this once. He says, oh, that's great. Do it again. And then I go for my own, exploding on it. If it drops his head, even better. If it drops his head as he kicks, I can knock him out. So a lot of people do this, and then what do? They let the leg continue momentum and strength, and it's off, and the nerve got shut down, so you either drop your hands or you cannot continue. I've seen this many times before. Yes, please.
Sorry. When you're kicking, on your opposite foot that you're standing on, what are you talking on rotation? How do you...
Good question. It's a little advanced, but I just saw for you to know. We call it a thumb. Yeah. Why is it a thumb? Because it's a thumb, you see? So as I do a movement, for instance, if the partner goes back, I see Steve and I start to move with him and I do left side, boom, boom, he moves back a step and I go for the kick. But maybe Steve has no fear. As I come back, he even, not only stays, he's right there, he's close. So as I do this, I start from making a step. So I make tatam and then I can move. I do this tatam and then it's for me so I can continue and move around it. Okay, so you can either, simple way for you for today, of course you will continue the advanced training you have forward with Jeff and Steve and all those great guys, but at the beginning, as you make a movement, step, otherwise, this way. Doesn't make sense to come from here and do just this, unless it's only a setup. For a setup, you can do it. For power, you either switch or step.